Hello and welcome. I'm Raghav and today we are going to learn how to integrate Jenkins and Git to run our Protractor tests. And I will go very basic step by step. So if you have no prior knowledge on this topic, do not worry. I will start from scratch. So I will go on my Windows system and you can also follow this on Mac. And here I have my Jenkins started. So just in case you do not know how I have started Jenkins, I have also created a job here. You can watch the earlier session where I have discussed on how to run Protractor framework from Jenkins, and I will also provide the link of that video in the description of this video, or you can go to my website, that is automationstepbystep.com, and here it is. If you go to online courses and if you click on Protractor here, you will get all the videos of this playlist. So you can just watch the earlier video in case you have not watched. And in the earlier video, we had started Jenkins. We have also created this job on Jenkins, that is Protractor test. And if I go inside this job, here you can see in this job, we had added this command to run our Protractor test. And we do not have to add the folder location because that we have already added in the general section. If I go to advanced, I have already added the location of my Protractor demo folder where I have all my Protractor framework. Now here in the job, you will find a link for source code management. If you go here, you will see here we have all these options, none, git and subversion. So I will go to git, and in case you do not find git here, you can add the plugin for git. So you can go to your Jenkins dashboard and go to manage Jenkins and go to manage plugins and go to the available section. I will show you, in my case it will be here in the installed section. So if I just search for git plugin, you can see it is here. So you can just go to your available section, search for git plugin and install it, and then you will have this option for git here. And here I will give my repository of the project. So in the earlier session, we had created our GitHub repository where we have our project. So I will just sign in on GitHub. And you can also use any other repository if you are using other than GitHub. So I will just sign in here. And here is our repository for Protractor. We created this Protractor framework, and I will just copy the URL. You can also copy it from this main address bar, and then I will provide the URL here, and that's it. Now the other thing I will do is, if I go to my general section, and here I'm just going to remove this for now. Use custom workspace, I'm going to remove it, otherwise it will clone on the same folder. I do not want this. Or you can also give some other folder. For example, I will create a new folder here. I will say Jenkins projects, and I will copy this and put here in use custom workspace. And even if you do not give this, it will clone the project from GitHub to the Jenkins folder. So you can skip this if you do not want to use a custom folder, otherwise just do it here. And I have added the GitHub URL here, and then in the build section I am just keeping the same command. So I will say apply, save, and I will say here build now. And if I go to the logs, so you can see it is now taking it out from GitHub, and now it is running our test on the project that it has cloned from Git. So if I show you the logs, you can see here it is now building on this project, and now it is cloning the repository from this particular GitHub URL, and here it is putting it here in Jenkins project. So if I now go to this location on my folder, you can see if I now go to Jenkins project, it has cloned the entire project from GitHub, and now it is running the test on this project. So now you do not have to keep the project on the local system where you have Git. You can just keep your project on GitHub and you can do all the commit and push from your local system on this GitHub repository. With this, we have already learned in the earlier sessions. So if you go here, we have this how to upload project on Git version control. This we have already learned. And now you can use Jenkins along with Git. And now you can run your projects directly cloning from Git and then running on Jenkins. So I hope this session was very useful for you. If you have any questions or any doubts, please write them down in the comments section below and I will try to answer as soon as I can. Do share your knowledge with others and thank you so much for watching.